In today's session, we will learn about mitochondria, plastids and nucleus, the three very important cell organelles. We'll begin our class with the first organelle, that is mitochondria. It is an autonomous cell organelle, that is, it has its own DNA and ribosomes. The ribosomes are 70S type, and so it appears as it is a prokaryotic cell within a eukaryotic cell. The mitochondria was observed in the flight muscle of insects by Kolliker in year 1880, and the term mitochondria was given by C. Benda. Now they are basically found in those cells whose metabolic state is very active, so they are numerous in number in liver and muscle cells. When you talk about the structure, it is a sausage shaped structure. It is having the double wall, that is outer wall and inner wall, or outer membrane or inner membrane. In between the outer and the inner membrane is a space which is known as mitochondrial space, and the inner membrane is having a finger like folds which are known as cristae. The mitochondria has a fluid inside it. That fluid is known as matrix. Now the cristae is further having the F1 particles or oxysomes, which are directly involved in the production of ATP. The mitochondria is involved in the Krebs cycle for energy generation. Now the function of the mitochondria. The mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell, so which clearly indicate that it is basically involved in the synthesis of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, which is the energy currency for our cell or body. Now next organelle is the plastids. These are also autonomous cell organelles, and they are present basically in plant cells. They are having their own DNA and ribosomes, which are again 70S type. The most common plastid that you have learned in your 9th standard is the chloroplast, which is a green pigment containing plastid, that is chlorophyll, and it is involved in the photosynthesis. So plastids are basically many types. Few are there to store the material like starch, lipids and proteins, and few are the colored plastids which are providing the color to the things. So here is a chart that gives you the elaborate description about the different type of plastids along with the storage material that they store in them. Note them down in your copy. Now let us come to the next cell organelle, which is the most important cell organelle and the controlling center of the cell, that is the nucleus. It is the largest cell organelle. It controls all the activities of the cell. It is also known as brain of the cell. Besides that, it also involves the reproduction, and it stores the genetic material, which is basically DNA. It is spherical or round in shape, and it is having its own membrane, which is known as nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope, which is double layered. Now, on the basis of number of nucleus, a cell can be uninucleated, that is with one nuclei, binucleated, that is with two nuclei, and multinucleated, that is with many nuclei. Now let us see the detailed structure of nucleus. Now you will be seeing the membrane, which is known as nuclear envelope, which is a double wall membrane. The nuclear envelope is in continuation with rough endoplasmic reticulum, which is involved in the protein synthesis. Inside the nuclear membrane is the fluid, which is known as nucleoplasm. Now you will see that this nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane is not continuous. It is innervated by tiny pores, which are known as nuclear pores, and these nuclear pores allow the exchange of material between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Next is the nucleoplasm, which is a jelly-like fluid that is present within the nuclear membrane, and this nucleoplasm contains the thread-like material, which is known as chromatin, a very densely stained body which is known as nucleolus and RNA. Now the chromatin is further divided into two types, that is euchromatin and heterochromatin. Now the heterochromatin is the condensed form of chromatin and it take up the darker stain and do not undergo the process of transcription, whereas the euchromatin is the dispersed form of chromatin that take up the lighter stain and is active transcriptionally. Transcription is the process where DNA is changed to RNA. Detail about this transcription you will learn in your senior classes, that is in 12th we will learn detail of the transcription. So this is all about the most important cell organelle which act as the brain. The nuclear envelope separates the cytoplasm and the nucleoplasm. Besides that, the major work of nucleolus is to synthesis the RNA. So these are all the parts of the nucleus. Today we have learned about all the three organelles which are having the double layered structure. That is, they are covered by the two envelopes. That's all for the day. Thank you.